Hey, what is going on, Guardians? Nem with Planet Destiny here, and it's Friday, which means that Xur is back in the world of Destiny, and this week he's located right over here in the Tower Hangar. So let's go ahead and make our way towards our favorite exotic vendor and see what he has for us in store this week. Hopefully he has some decent Forsaken exotics that he still hasn't sold. I don't think he sold the Shards of Galenor yet. I need to pick that up on my PlayStation 4 account. Alright, let's go ahead and see what this guy has for us this week. Okay. Alright, Xur, buddy. You want to talk about it, pal? You're kind of missing something here. Where did you drop the weapon somewhere, dude? Okay. Wings of Sacred Dawn for the Warlock, Aeon Saves for the Titans, and Frosties for the Hunters. Wings of Sacred Dawn for the Warlock with its Tome of Dawn intrinsic perk. When Dawnblade is equipped, aiming weapons while you're in midair suspends you there for a short time. Weapon hits extend this effect's durations. This is one of the first few exotics that you get when you're running through the initial campaign for Destiny 2, so most likely you guys will already have these, so this is a hard pass. Aeon Safe, ha, you thought, and the Frosties for the Hunters. With its rapid cooldown intrinsic perk, increased grenade, melee, and dodge regeneration while sprinting. Dodging increases your sprint speed. The Frosties are actually a pretty fantastic exotic for Crucible. They have a lot of utility by, you know, just giving you rapid cooldowns as you're sprinting. So if you spec out correctly, you know, with Paragon mods and stuff like that, your cooldowns are going to be incredibly fast. So I really recommend picking up the Frosties. We'll go. Of course, we're going to go through the Aeon saves, even though they're absolutely terrible in terms of perks. Aeon Energy intrinsic perk. Summoning a barricade grants the following to nearby Aeon cult allies: grenade energy to warlocks, barricade energy to titans, and dodge energy to hunters, and other allies receive a fraction of the shared energy. Again, these are not great. This is a hard pass. Just don't waste your shards on these guys. Their utility is bar to none, so yeah. Hard skip. Of course, we have the Faded Engram, so let's go ahead and pick one up to see if I get an exotic armor piece with interesting perks. Nope, I got the Cold Heart, because again, that's all I seem to get from these engrams. Thank you for giving me my 5 shards. And of course, we have the 5 of Swords, which will give you additional modifiers for the Nightfall Strikes in order for you to get that crispy 100k score. I expect a fix for Xur very, very soon. If a fix does end up happening, we will update the description down below with the weapon and just a quick summary of what it does. But yeah, this was a rather disappointing week for Xur. Sorry about that, guys. Well, with that being said, I hope you guys have a good weekend, and thank you for watching. We appreciate you here at Planet Destiny.